Hello and welcome to episode 13 of my survival here on Minecraft. Right, today I am going to be building a brand new house for myself with iron doors so no villagers can get in. Right, and while we're doing that, we're listening to Kevin Wilson, so enjoy the video and enjoy the music.
Like a railway fiddler's hammer splitting wood. on its edge, but he just had to. He got up, walked around, then rigged off all the legs. Then one by one he smashed the cunt's cross Snakey's ugly head. If his brain weren't so well padded, he'd be dead. But Snake just shook his skull and blinked a bit and slowly looked around. Then chucked the right that would have knocked the war memorial down. And the force of it sent Lofty flying, crashing through the wall. Now there's a doorway where there weren't one there before. He landed ass up in the shithouse with his feet stuck in the air. With bricks and shit and broken glass and paper everywhere. And caked in that crap, he ripped the dunny off the wall. And armed with that, fuck all brains went back for more. He slammed that dunny over Snakey's head, shattering it to bits. Peppering him with porcelain and splattering him with shit. And there was teeth amongst the muck and shit. Whose they were, you couldn't tell. But it looked like Lofty lost an ear as well. And Snake's right eye was swollen shut from where he'd caught one hard. Van Dinkum made it look as black as Ernie Dingo's ass. But with all the pieces missing and with all the blood and gore, they weren't as fucking ugly as before. There was flesh and hair and skin and bone and blood splashed on the wall. And them two bastards wallowing in it, rolling across the floor. And the publican just scratched his balls, wondering, looking round. Should he clean the bastard up or burn it down? Most blues you see turn out to be a win or loss or a draw. But fucked if I've seen both opponents lose a fight before. And I heard Snakey say to Lofty as they crawled towards the bar.
Fuck me, Snooker. Want a game of darts?
It was the front bar, Featherbrain, non-title fight. Two blokes the size of buffaloes, big but not too bright. And no one gives two knobs a goat shit who was wrong or right. It's the front bar, Featherbrain, non-title fight. It was the front bar, Featherbrain, non-title fight. Two blokes the size of buffaloes, big but not too bright. And no one gives two knobs a goat shit who was wrong or right. At the front bar, Featherbrain, non-title fight. It was the front bar, Featherbrain, non-title fight. Two blokes the size of buffaloes, big but not too bright. Much of me time buying dinner and wine and me money on flowers and lollies, only to find that what's on me mind isn't on hers and she's sorry. So I've made up some lines to save wasting time and keep me from blowing me brass. I'm ever so cool, I just prop on the stool right next to hers and I ask, do you fuck on first dates? Does your dad own a brewery? Could I feed your tits? Or would you show them to me? Cause you got a nice head and you look pretty honest. So me face will be leaving in quarter of an hour. I'd like you to be honest. You know how it feels when you first meet a Sheila and the bullshit you gotta go through. Like calling her up and telling her you love her when all that you love is just a screw. But she wants to hold hands and you to meet her old man and sit around for hours and talk. But me new method is you just cut through the shit and get down to the goodies straight off. Do you fuck on first dates? Does your dad own a brewery? Could I feel your tits? Or would you show them to me? Do you sleep in the nick? Do you give head very often? If we can decide your place or mine, we
can fuck off then. So the next time you see a good looking Sheila and you'd give a week's pay to hold her, don't sit acting dumb, just run a full on and drop a few lines that I told you. This new method of mine might not work every time, but then again, no method will. I've been spat at and slapped and needing the knack of this, but then I got a few fucks as well. Do you fuck on first dates? Does your dad own a brewery? Could all be your tits? Or would you show them to me? If the answer is no, too many questions above, then be a good sport and give me the name of a girlfriend who does.
Family planted that first row of apple trees in the Dickens family orchard back in 1953. They waited till that first crop was juicy, red and ripe, then picked and pressed and bottled Dickens cider. It was the tastiest fizz cider ever made. And their slogan was, gotta have a dick insider every day. And I'd sing along with their radio jingle, and although...
I did try to make a call, but she did that. I didn't think that fucking phone. I'm your fucking Time for bed. at me in front of me mates. Setting farts on fire's blokey stuff. Sheilas ain't supposed to do that, eh? You're a funny bugger, Betty, and I've always said, you sure know how to have fun. So pull up your knickers and give them back their matches. Come on, Betty, I'm taking you home. Can't bet before you start a bushfire. Can't bet I'm taking you home. Oh, come on, Betty. Competition's over. You're embarrassing me in front of me, mates. They don't want to see your new tattoo. You ain't got a tattoo. Oh, fuck me, hooray. You're a funny bugger, Betty, and I've always said you sure know how to have fun. But you don't even like fucking ACDC. Come on, Betty. I'm taking you home.
Right, I'm going to end this video here. I'm going to say thank you very much for watching. Please like, subscribe, share, hit the bell for notifications. And tomorrow I will be carrying on building this house. It will be done tomorrow. I'm going to do another. Yeah, I'm going to make it three high. We told you three high. So four high. So then I'm going to put a upstairs and a roof, and then jobs are good. And but that's what I'm going to do tomorrow. So yeah, I'm going to say. Please like, subscribe, share, hit that bell for notifications, like I say, and I will see you all tomorrow. Bye!